Officials from the Office of the President, led by the Minister of State for Economic Planning, Peter Gwang, told the Committee of the Presidential Affairs, chaired by Jessica Ababiko, that the stock of Most Excellent Order of the Pearl of Africa and Distinguished Order of the Pearl of Africa medals have run out, yet these are bestowed upon visiting heads of states. Although the Presidential Awards Committee has been allocated only 339 million shillings, officials urged the committee to save the President from untold embarrassment by approving 4.23 billion shillings for the procurement of these medals.
Let's first appreciate that issue of giving medals is one initiative which has an a law of this parliament. On top of that, we as presidents have planned to have money be given, be put there, so for in case any head of state comes and the president deems it fit to award the medal, we must have resources to do that. And I want to say this is one of the areas where there's no money, but it's little money, but we shall work within what we have.
The Office of the President is also seeking 5 billion shillings to undertake maintenance works at National Leadership Institute in Changkwanzi after sinking 7.9 billion in its construction, but not a single coin has been allocated by the Minister of Finance.
National Leadership Institute, on that table, I see a zero. Is it an error or it's a... That one, you'll forgive me, maybe they corrected it when they were presenting.
Maintenance of the infrastructure at NALI. They have 1 billion for feeding the soldiers at NALI. Yes, that is all.
But they don't have development
component. For development component.
Why?
The zero, in fact, the development component.
Why?
That's why we are agitating for them.
This committee has to go and see what is there. So that if you are talking about rehabilitation, we will be able to understand, because what we know is we gave you money. We will be able now to see the new gaps. But without seeing the new gaps, the question is, how far did we go with the usage of the money?
The Office of the President also appealed to Parliament to approve a budget request to tune of 10 billion for the construction of offices of RDCs across the country. They also seek 12.2 billion to facilitate RDCs, who are 146 in number, but of these, 107 are renting office space. However, MPs protested funding to RDCs, saying it isn't urgent at the moment because the mandate for RDCs isn't well streamlined, as the law is not clear on who RDCs can hold accountable.
RDCs are not doing government roles, you know, in whatever capacity they are deployed. RDCs are being made to mobilize for NRM, and we strongly believe that RDCs should be paid under the NRM party. We have seen on many incidences that RDCs are being sent out to stop opposition members from either accessing radio stations or for setting up meetings, which is so sad.
There is one land grabber who wants to claim the entire 5 square miles of land, the entire parish of Obeah. And in this clip, this woman is trying to report the excesses of the RDC, who went with the agents of this land grabber and forced the community to sign the documents to have them leave the land. We need this kind of training.
There are also areas where I have found their work wanting. Some of them, the areas have been, because the work of monitoring is the one which is listed before the RDCs. It is a constitutional under Article 203. It's also within Section 71 of the Local Government Act that the RDC is meant to monitor both central and local government.
Minister Ogwang struggled to convince the Committee of Presidential Affairs on the request for shillings 8.3 billion to facilitate newly recruited presidential advisors. The committee wondered why the government spends a lot of money on presidential advisors whose performance is unknown to the public. Meanwhile, Peter Ogwang asked the committee to support the budget for economic monitoring, saying his oversight inspections have unearthed a mess in implementation of projects. He revealed that 128 government officials have been indicted and soon facing prosecution. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.